Here's an experiment. We have 25, perhaps 30,000 genes in a human and about, you know, so say comparable numbers of genes in other higher organisms, other mammals, and so on. And the different cell types are different because of the different sets of genes that they are expressing at any one moment. Let's see if that is, in fact, a reasonable way to explain cell differentiation. You can take an egg and remove its nucleus. Let's do that. Originally, it was done for a toad, a Xenopus, a relative of a frog. And more recently, of course, it's been done with higher organisms. So now we have what's called an enucleated egg, an egg without a nucleus. And we can take the nucleus of an adult cell and transplant it into the egg. The egg begins to develop, and under the right conditions, and with a bit greater complexity than I'm showing here, this egg with an adult nucleus in it instead of its normal nucleus can develop into a normal adult. And this is the essence of cloning in frogs and sheep and cows and, more recently, cats and dogs and you name it, and eventually, I'm afraid, also humans, regardless of the ethics of the whole thing. But this is cloning organisms the way you've read about this in newspapers or seen it in the specials on TV. So you can conclude from this kind of experiment that the nucleus of all cells of an organism, in the case of the frog, it was an intestinal cell, but any cell can be used pretty much. All cells, all somatic cells of an organism, contain the same genes as you would find in a fertilized egg.